Thank you again to the concert band and the choir. Fantastic job on those groups. Welcome, everyone. I'm Mark Murphy, the principal of the Lackawanna Trail Junior Senior High School. And on behalf of the Lackawanna Trail School Board of Directors, the administration, the faculty, staff, it gives me great pleasure to welcome you as the honored guests of the class of 2016 and to formally begin the 60th commencement ceremony at Lackawanna Trail High School. These commencement exercises are designed to recognize and celebrate the accomplishments of this senior class and to conclude their studies at Lackawanna Trail with the awarding of diplomas. And while my welcome will introduce tonight's program and the graduates who receive their diplomas tonight, those of us in this audience know that this class needs no introduction. After all, this is the class. These students seated behind me are the ones who returned Lackawanna Trail to three district title games this year. A silver medal finish in football, another in ladies basketball, and one dominating championship victory that yielded gold for our girls softball team just last week. Members of this class have entertained us on the stages of Lackawanna Trail High School. They've performed with honors music ensembles. Some of them have earned partial or even full ride scholarships as a result of their dedication in the classroom, in the weight room, and on the athletic fields. While others are budding entrepreneurs and craftsmen who will stimulate our economy for years to come. The class of 2016 has amassed some pretty impressive accomplishments along the way. But don't forget you have a little bit of fun too. Don't forget, these are the seniors that remind us that hashtag devils aren't blue. They taught Mr. Pierce and Miss Malone how to lean and nap. And they were persuasive enough to somehow convince this otherwise reserved principal to literally slip and slide down the hill in what was otherwise a very nice, perfectly good-fitting suit from Joseph McLean. None of them seem to want my dry cleaning bill, but that's my story for another day. Speaking of taking responsibility of those seniors, graduates, some of our community members called today. They would like their political science back. But on a very serious note, of the 62 students who will walk across the stage this evening, two-thirds of them plan to attend a 2- or 4-year college. They're headed to Temple, to Maryland, the University of Scranton, Susquehanna, St. Joseph's, Fordham, the Pennsylvania State University, Willis, Liberty, York, and many more. Slightly less than one-third of them will enter the workforce next year with a range of trades, and 4 of them will continue their training at local vocational and career centers. For a small school, these graduates have beaten the odds. To them, I say, you have made it. You're here, you have studied, you've learned, you've performed, you've been tested in our classrooms, on the stage, and on the athletic fields. And through all of that, you have endured and you have succeeded. You have the skills and the knowledge to move forward, to embrace the future, to collaborate, to create, and to achieve. And it doesn't matter what the next chapter has in store for you, as long as you work toward being the best at it. If your 4 years in high school has taught you nothing else, it should be that no one is going to hand you anything out there. The challenges you face will no longer present themselves in the form of a deadline for Mr. Powell's English class, 2-score deficit late in the game, or opening on jitters. But all of those experiences have prepared you for what lies ahead. 60 graduating classes have now come and gone through the halls of Lackawanna Trail High since the school opened in 1956. Each of them walked to the stage wearing a cap and gown just like you are tonight. And every one of them had a vision for their future. Many of our alumni have passionately chased their pursuit of their dreams, and they've recognized great success along the way. Wall Street brokers, NFL coaches, players, doctors, lawyers, businessmen and women, and some of our Commonwealth's most celebrated agriculturalists. But don't go about life trying to recreate their story. Construct your own. As Steve Jobs said, your time is limited. So don't waste it living someone else's. Go out and make your mark on this world class of 2016. Experience all that life has to offer and give back whenever possible. Don't you dare be afraid of failure. I'll let you in on a little secret. Everyone here has failed, and we've all lived and dealt the story of that. There are countless examples of leaders, inventors, and intellectual geniuses who have failed and rallied to succeed. Here's another secret. You will fail, and you will pick yourself up by the bootstraps, and you will succeed again. There are so many worse than the first stories out there. Why would you waste another moment if you're in failure? Embrace it. Get inspired by it. Go after it. Get tough and overcome it. It's that type of determination, in fact, and that leadership that we expect from you, graduates. We know that you're up for it. You're poised. You're confident. And we haven't seen you back down in 6 years. Your class leaves behind a legacy of success and honor. You're not the little class that could. You are the little class that did. You are shining examples of who we are as a community. I'm a shining example of what a Lackawanna Trail line is made of. Continue to believe in yourselves and in your ability. Be proud to be a Lackawanna Trail line. And never forget where you come from, because we are so very, very proud of you. It's been an extreme honor to know each of you and serve as your principal. I hope that you come back and visit often. On behalf of everyone here gathered tonight, congratulations on your achievement. And welcome to your commencement ceremony.